Testing thumb MP flexion. Your patient's hand will be in a supinated position, resting on a table or flat surface. First thing you'll have your patient do is bring their thumb all the way across their palm, but keeping the distal part of their thumb extended. Go ahead and do that for me, Rachel. Now bring it back. Because she's able to do that, I would grade her as a 3. Now, because she was able to do that, I proceed forward to see if she can test for a 4 or 5. So I will have her perform that about halfway again, about right there. I will stabilize the first metacarpal here, and then I will add resistance to the proximal phalanx of the thumb here. So go ahead and resist me, Rachel. 3, 2, 1. There we go. So according to how her resistance is, I'd grade that as a 4 or a 5. You can bring your thumb back. If she could not bring her thumb into full range of motion while in this position without resistance, then I will have her in a gravity minimized or gravity eliminated position, as shown here. So go ahead, Rachel. What I want you to do is bring your thumb as close to the table as possible, and then come back up. Because she's able to do that, that'd be a grade 2. If she could not do that, or if there was minimal motion going on, then I would palpate the flexor pollicis brevis, which is found about right here. If I feel this muscle firing, that would be a grade 1, and if I do not feel it firing, that would be a grade 0.